to have something different. Till now, we had lovely talks on research, development, engineering, and other related areas. Now I'm going to present you something which is which has roots in roots from Switzerland. We have a wide rural population in Rajasthan. I would like to give you the background where skill as a concept is home industry. We have absolutely great carpenters, absolutely great carvers, absolutely great painters, coloring, batik, you name it, we have it. But then it was Dr. Joshi, who is at present in Switzerland. He is basically from Rajasthan. He thought that why not we train our Rajasthani people, the rural people, into a qualified professionals. In Switzerland, usually students, along with the schooling, they have some kind of a skill built into them. They actually go to the industry and practice. Sometimes it is taught in the school. What they call as Swiss dual system. Now it was Dr. Joshi's idea that why not we bring it to Rajasthan and give the benefit of this Swiss dual system to the basically to the Rajasthani student population. Now we have our own academic bodies, our own academic regulations, and our own realistic Indian difficulties where we just cannot bring in the Swiss standards to India. It is just not possible, not that we are really expecting to be another Switzerland. So what we thought was that we at BSDU, we thought of developing this particular dual system of education, or what is called as the skills, suitable to Indian academic requirement, Indian monitoring bodies, and the setup. So eventually we therefore ended up having qualifications of the kind where it is to develop qualifications which will offer a modular kind of certificate programs, what we call BVoc, that is the Bachelor of Vocation, MVoc, which is Master of Vocation, and then PhD in related skills areas. Now I'm sure you will be really, this particular word, skills, is nothing new to anybody. We are actually the insistence is on-hand experience and less insistence on theory. Moving in this direction, the kind of programs that we have started to suit the Indian requirement, but basically the initial setup and the curriculum is brought from Switzerland, mostly the practical aspects, we offer these kind of degree programs, skill certificate, skill diploma, advanced diploma, BVoc, MVoc, and PhD. Since this is a totally new setup and a new concept, we also train the trainers for the programs. We have faculty development programs, executive development programs, and programs on industry demand. See the kind of faculties we are projecting: faculty of manufacturing skills, faculty of automotive skills, faculty of electrical skills, faculty of informatics, photonics, and robotics skills, faculty of woodwork and interior fitting skills, faculty of office administration skills, faculty of healthcare and paramedic skills, faculty of building construction and utility skills, faculty of innovation, entrepreneurship, incubation, and IPR skills, faculty of agricultural skills, faculty of logistics skills, and faculty of textile skills, and faculty of hospitality and tourism. Moving forward, the new faculties, in fact, I'm sure most of you are aware, the number of skills that are being introduced by the Government of India is increasing year by year. So as and when whatever is relevant and most current, we also intend to propose in Bhartiya Skill Development University. In this direction, new faculties proposed for 2019-20 are Faculty of Media and Entertainment Skills, Faculty of Industrial Security Skills, Faculty of Leather and Leatherite Skills, Faculty of Plastic Skills. See, in fact, as I told you earlier, it is a Swiss dual system. We have the Swiss trainers coming to India and training the Indian partners. Together, they will be teaching the Indian students. So we have, because just to actually what you call, to be in line with the academic compliances, we have the approved list of BWOC programs for the year 2018-19. BWOC in manufacturing skills, automotive skills, carpenter skills, construction skills, electrical skills, IT networking skills, office administration skills, HVAC and R skills, diploma in medical nursing and assistant skills, BWOC in agriculture skills, plumbing skills, logistics skills, garment making and fabric printing skills, hospitality and tourism skills, machine learning and AI skills, renewable energy and technology skills, and entrepreneurship skills. BWOC in the, for the year 1920, this is the future. We have food processing skills, BWOC in graphics and printing, BWOC in internet journalism, BWOC in advertising, short film making, animation and games, industry security, telecom, robotics and 3D printing, automotive skills, and construction equipment skills. As I mentioned in the beginning, we are probably the only university, we start from BWOC, MWOC, and research. So in this direction, the current 2018-19 MWOC programs are automotive, carpenter, smart power systems, embedded systems, and entrepreneurship skills. The idea and the ambition in the university is that we intend to have at least one new MWOC program which is most relevant and which is most popular. Compliances. This I already mentioned in the beginning. Since it is it's an Indian setup, compliances are a top priority. Therefore, these are the compliances we follow. UGC, National Skills Qualification, AICTE, NSQF, guidelines for, from the respective council skills, national occupation standards, and skills qualification packs. In fact, the curriculum is designed purely based on the Sector Skills Council recommendations and qualification packs. We have an expert committee for that. This is exactly how the skills education functions. The most important and probably the different, as I call you, feature is this. At the entry level, every odd semester is theory, where insistence on theory is less, hands-on experience is more. In the even semester, the same student goes and practices the exactly same skill in a live industrial environment. At the end of first year, he has the liberty to go out, join a job, and come to the third semester whenever he wants. This is probably the most attractive feature of this particular program. He continues like that for three years, he gets a BWOC. Two more years, MWOC. Minimum 3 years is the research program. This is what I told you just now. The kind of skills equivalence is something interesting, which I thought we'll discuss with my August audience. See, level 4 skill certificate is 12 years roughly, 10,000 hours of learning in school, minimum 17 years of age. Level 5 skills diploma is 13 years or 8,000 hours in school. Level 6 advanced diploma is 12,000 hours or minimum 19 years of age. Level 7 is BWOC, minimum 20 years of age. Level 8 PG diploma, 21 years of age. Level 9 MWOC, 22 years of age, and level 10 PhD is minimum 25 years of age. By the way, I'm sure you will be interested to know exactly as to how we really base our curriculum development. We have a board of studies having vice chancellors from different universities, industry professionals drawn from different industries, various sector skill council CEOs, and other related professionals. You can, I'll just show the list. We meet twice a year, sometimes three times a year, depending on the need. All the curriculums, rules and regulations, everything is updated at the BOS level, and then it is implemented. Also, we have an All India Association of Skills Universities, where the Indian skills universities meet together to take this particular program forward. Last point. We intend to promote this program. The main reason why we have come here is to let people know that there is a program of this kind in Rajasthan and that it is very much appreciated. In fact, the Rajasthan government, they straight away told us openly that they are looking at us as to see what we are doing. Now, we thought that we will bring it out here, show it to you people, get your opinion and kind of a feedback. We are also looking forward for collaborations in terms of skills or universities. Last point, internationalization was discussed today. Everybody talked about internationalization. I would like to add a comment. We are also interested because skills education is very prevalent in Germany. It is really prevalent in Europe. Therefore, maybe we are really looking for that kind of collaborations abroad too.